Oh, baby.
You here, Daddy?
Yeah, I'm over here.
Kenndals in recovery. She has her cast on. She is... She was a little fussy, but just because she was laying down. But now Dad has her, and she's being such a snuggle bug. She's doing so good. We're waiting to be admitted into her hospital room. And yeah, her cast doesn't have the coloring on it yet. Now it's waterproof, and then they're gonna put a color over it. So we'll decide on that upstairs, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, Carlos votes black with red flames.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll check back in a little bit. We are in our room. Kenndal is in her crib, talking to Dad for a little bit. She's getting a little fussy. We're nervous that she's starting to feel a little bit of pain, which I don't think, because her medicine won't wear off close to 8 to 10 hours, he said, but we never know. So we are gonna start medicine soon, so at least it builds up in our system. We put on a movie, Scoobs, I think it's called, and we have those fun lights, which is awesome. I think they're actually really cool. And we're just kind of switching back and forth of calming Kenndal down, so. That's awesome for right now. Let's look at Kenndal. We have the waterproof cast on right now, and we are gonna get a colored cast on top of that, of course. It's really cold. Got some socks on her feet. A little lamb. So we're just hanging out. I think it's, what time is it? Where's the clock? Oh, okay, it's almost 8 o'clock. I'm exhausted. Carlos is exhausted. And hungry, and Kenndal's exhausted. It's been a long day, so hopefully she just gets a really good night's rest. No pain, medicine works, and, well, we just all get some sleep.
I'm not gonna lie, right now is extremely hard for me. I can't really hold her in a good way. She's so stiff, and most of my time I do is I hold her, and she's definitely getting in some pain, frustration and stuff. So right now is definitely tough. I just don't know how to hold her, how she's comfortable, pain's starting to kick in. They just gave her some pain meds and she's eating for the first time now, so that could be part of it too. She's definitely trying to move, but she can't, and I think that's frustrating, and I get that. But yeah, I just can't wait until I find a good time that this is all over and I look back and think, wow, that was so short. It was no big deal. I want to fast forward to that. But right now we're stuck in it and we'll get through it. We have a lot of prayer warriors with us and we have a great God, so I'm not scared. It's now midnight, the last however long, I think since 7, 5 hours, she's been crying like this. We've tried pain meds, I've tried laying her on me on her stomach, laying on her back, with a pillow in between her legs, laying her on her side, releasing her gas, giving her food. I mean, we've tried a lot. I don't know what to do right now. I just want her to be as comfortable as possible, and it's really hard when she's just not. At one point, we thought the G-tube was the issue, so we checked it, and I noticed it wasn't turning like it should have, so I released the balloon. Like, I took all the water out of it, pushed it down a little farther, and put it back in, and now I don't think that's necessarily the issue. I think the spinal cast is definitely rubbing on it, so a doctor's gonna...
Sorry about that, the nurse came in, and sorry it's so dark, it's midnight. We're pretty tired. I've been up since 3 a.m. because Kenndal woke up last night, so I'm exhausted almost 24 hours. She's still crying. I just laid her down. I think that's the hardest thing for me, is usually when I pick her up and hold her and snuggle her, she's fine. But with even the cast on, I think it's almost worse when I'm holding her. Like, she cries more. And that's really hard on me. And I just want to hold her and snuggle her until she falls asleep. But I can't. They
The nurse suggested morphine, a small dose. Hopefully that's all we need. She falls asleep, and then tomorrow is a new day and it gets better and we won't have to use pain meds like that again. We could just stick with morphine and Tylenol. Oh, baby girl. And that's the update for now. Last night was rough, and I mean 12 hours plus of crying. She is finally asleep. That was the only way we could get her asleep, to stay asleep. This staff here has been the most amazing staff ever. I mean, the care that they give Kenndals is outstanding. One issue that we think we're having is she is not urinating, so they had to use a catheter, a half catheter last night, to get some urine out, and I think that relieved her some. She has not urinated since, and she's getting IV fluids and food, so we think that that is definitely part of it, the issue of what's going on. I think there's a lot going on. I mean, she did have surgery. She cried, her throat probably hurts, her head probably hurts, everything hurts. While she's asleep, we're gonna step out to go get some food, we'll be right back. We're gonna let the nurse know that we're stepping out. And yeah, so good morning guys, today's gonna be a better day. Speaking it into existence. So we've been trying to figure out what's happening, like why is she so much pain? I mean, morphine didn't work, we just didn't know what to do. We just talked to the surgeon, he said muscle spasms are actually very common, and as you can tell, it's like, it's a random, like she almost gets asleep and then she jolts. And she's having muscle spasms, and we have her on 3 different muscle relaxants right now. And I told the surgeon that, but he wants to use a different one that will really work, like real stuff, and it will get her sleepy as well. So she falls asleep, her muscles will relax, and sometimes they wake up and it's like, obviously they still have some uncomfortableness, that's a word, but their muscles aren't spazzing like before. The first 2 days, first day is extremely hard, he says. So that makes me feel better that we have a solution. We found the problem, we have a solution, and we're gonna do it. I'm very excited to see the outcome. I just want her to sleep for her own good. I think, I mean, it's 9 o'clock and she's been crying since yesterday at like 6, right Carlos? 6-ish?
Yeah, 7.
7. So, I mean, this is a long time of just crying. And I think the longest time that she fell asleep was maybe 20-ish minutes. So, we're gonna pray that this works. Hi guys, I am back. It is around 12:30. Kenndals been eating great. She's been taking food pretty darn well. We got our car seat works. They just altered it a little bit by pinning this hard pillow in, and then it works. It'll work. Kenndal is snuggling with Dad. It's so hard to hold her. And pain's been getting a little bit better. We have been putting tons of muscle relaxants, hoping that the spasms go away. We still see some, just not as much as before, right? Would you agree?
Yeah.
They're gonna have to cut the cast a little bit lower so her G-tube isn't rubbing up on that, but that's later tonight. And that's really all for now. We're watching The Little Mermaid. It's the live action one. And we're both pretty tired, but we are getting there. Right, babe?
Yeah.
All right, I think we're gonna lay her in her bed because she is out, so might as well let her be super comfy in her bed and we can get some rest as well. Thank you, guys. So we talked to the surgeon we talked to the doctor that's on staff, and they all think, even the orthopedics and everybody like that, already in charge, thinks that Kenndal really just could go home. She'll be put on pain meds. That was kind of going to be either way anyways. And the reason that she's just so uncomfortable is because, well, she just got put into a practically full body cast and she can't move her legs, which I would be very uncomfortable as well. And it's not like I can really explain it to her. So that probably makes it worse. I think for the next few days, it's going to be like this no matter what. So why not have her at home as comfortable as can be with no IV in her arm? And, you know, just home. Home always makes things good. And we'll start getting into a schedule pattern and stuff like that. Carlos is packing up now. He's gonna take some stuff to the car, close out of the Ronald McDonald House, bring up the stroller. Hopefully she fits in the stroller. We had to alter the car seat, so might have to alter the stroller, but we'll see. I'm just gonna pick up, you know, put the couch back into our couch, or take our bed and put it back into a couch. Maybe move the recliner back. I just don't want to leave this place a huge mess. So I'll be doing that. Kendall right now is relaxing. That's another thing. It's like, we think she needs to sleep, but they have to take vitals every so often, and they have to do this, they have to do that. It's just how it is. And I don't think it's helping her with the sleeping, and she's exhausted. So if we get home, maybe that will help as well. And yeah. We are on our way home. We got steak and shake. Really good.
This is the longest I've seen her rest, and she is already acting more like herself since we left, which brings me so much joy. I think we made the right decision, and we're going home. She's so calm. I haven't not seen her like this since before surgery. I'm so excited. I think it's still gonna be a hard road ahead of learning positionings for her. But I think we got this, right, Carlos? Yeah. Any last words?
Is it on me?
Any last words, though?
Stay safe.
Stay safe.